Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello everyone and good morning all of you. This is Ashima, your current affairs and banking awareness faculty on entry platform. And in this video, we'll be talking about everyday news events and current affairs. So the discussion is going to involve all the major news events that have been in the past day. And we'll be talking about all of them. They have been filtered out for your examination point of view that you can be benefited by this video. And this is a very concise video that has been made. So it has been made specifically keeping your examination in mind. So you can clearly share this video as it's a very small, concise video just for your everyday highlight update. So let's begin the discussion. And the first news event that we are going to talk about is IFFCO's. Now, related to IFFCO's, Indian Farmer Fertilizer Cooperative Limited Research and Development Unit has by the name Nano Biotechnology Research Center, it has signed an MOU with IIT Delhi recently. And this is for research, consultancy, knowledge transfer and collaborative projects. So basically, increasing the research and exchange of information regarding what people of IFFCO know and the what people of IIT Delhi know, for that purpose this MOU has been signed so that joint research activities can take place and they can share their research labs, their research work, their consultancies and everything related to that. So according to this MOU, it's going to help in the nanotechnology development domain in the future prospect. Now, IIT Delhi and IFFCO NBRC will be offering support by sharing their research laboratories for research work and their consultancies. Experts, engineers, scientists, they are going to work jointly with the researchers of IIT Delhi to solve problems associated with agriculture, environment, deploying innovative solutions. Next, we have is Asian Development Bank, ADB. ADB has recently approved a loan to support the state of Jharkhand in water supply infrastructure. So, as we have seen recently, World Bank had offered support to Punjab, whereas NABARD had offered support to Punjab, whereas ADB is offering support to Jharkhand. ADB has signed a loan of $112 million for Jharkhand, and the project is going to be for residents with offering continuous and quality water supply. So it will be in Husainabad, Chumri Talaya, Medininagar and Ranchi cities. In these cities, this is going to be implemented. The total fund which is required for the project is estimated at 160 million, out of which 48 million will be by the state government and the rest amount is going to be via ADB, which has come forward. About 940 kilometers of water distribution network is going to be established using these funds and the supply is going to be to more than 115,000 houses and it is expected to be completed by 2028. ADB current president is Masatsagu Asakawa, whereas Chief Minister of Jharkhand is Hemant Sorenji and the Governor of Jharkhand is Ramesh Bess. Next we have is a few one-liners. Them being Border Roads Organization, BRO, has constructed and blacktopped the highest motorable road in the world. That is at 19,300 feet, built at Umling La Pass in the eastern Jharkhand region. Now, this road which has been built, it is now the highest motorable road, whereas before this, the highest motorable road was in Bolivia at a height of about 18,953 feet on the volcano of Uturum. India's leading renewable energy company, Renew Power, has signed an MOU with Rack Bank Data Centers Limited. Now, this MOU has been signed by Renew Power, which is one of the most prominent companies in terms of renewable energy in India. And it will generate renewable sources through RackBank's high-scale data centers in India after a PPA will be signed. What is a PPA? That is a power purchase agreement. Union Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved the extension of Samagra Shiksha Abhiyan 2.0. So, this is an integrated scheme for school education from 2021 1st of April to 2026 31st of March with an outlay of about 3 lakh crore rupees. Now, the Union Government has decided to enhance the incentive with disabilities to 5,000 rupees and also extend the 6,000 transport incentive per annum to students to secondary level students for the difficulties that they face in the transportation in the difficult areas. IIT Roorkee has launched earthquake early warning mobile app called Uttarakhand Bhukamp Alert, which was sponsored by Uttarakhand State Disaster Management Authority, which is first earthquake early warning app of India. Before this, there has not been anyone which has been formed. Who is the current Chief Minister of Uttarakhand? That is going to be Pushkar Singh Dhami. Pushkar Singh Dhami is the current Chief Minister, whereas Governor is Baby Rani Maurya. Indian naval ship Khanjar has become the first Indian naval ship to call the heritage coastal port of Gopalpur, that is Gopalpur Post, which is in Odisha. Over there, the first heritage coastal port has been formed. It was on the occasion of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav and Swarnim Vijay Varsh. Agriculture and Processed Food Products Development Authority, APEDA, has signed a MOU with University of Agriculture Science, UAS, in Bangalore to boost the export of agricultural and processed food products, especially from the region of Karnataka. So that is APEDA for signing in an agreement on the same. Then IFFCO has signed MOU with IIT Delhi, which we have already seen. Tamil Nadu Chief Minister M.K. Stalin has launched Makkali Thedi Muruvatham. It's a doorstep healthcare scheme in which doorstep healthcare is going to be provided in terms of patients not needing to visit hospitals for every now and then or for every now and then treatment. And also, the need for patients to visit hospitals for treating non-communication diseases is going to be reduced. The door-to-door checkups will be available and women health volunteers will also be there in this. Germany has become the fifth country to sign International Solar Alliance Framework after the amendments. Denmark was the first to sign and ratify International Solar Alliance Framework Agreement after the amendments. The first one was Denmark, and the latest country is Germany, which is the fifth country to sign after all the amendments that have taken place. World Bank has signed a $250 million project with India for long-term dam safety program, that is for DRIP 2 mission. ICICI Prudential Insurance has partnered with NPCI to offer a UPI auto pay facility to the customers. So for offering the UPI facility auto pay feature, which is there, for that particular thing, NPCI has brought this ICICI Prudential Life Insurance. Both of them have come together for this. Then we have Aditya Birla Group Chairman Kumar Mangalam Birla, who has stepped down from non-executive director, non-executive chairman of Vodafone Idea. RBI has approved reappointment of Prakash Chandra. He is going to be the non-executive part-time chairman of RBL Bank for another 3 years now. Titagarh Weapons Limited has conducted a virtual function display of first train of Pune Metro, which is manufactured by a subsidiary which is based in Italy by the name Titagarh Pharma SPA Plant. Now, this is India's lightest metro train set as it is manufactured using aluminium, and it is for the first time that such a train has been built in India using aluminium, the lightest metro train set yet. SEBI has allowed Payments Bank to perform activities of investment bankers. Approval was given to offer easy access to investors to participate in public and rights issues using various payment avenues. Non-scheduled payments bank will be allowed to act as a banker to an issue BTI as per the norms which have been brought up. Ravi Kumar Dahiya, who is an Indian wrestler, has won silver medal in men's 57 kg freestyle category in Tokyo Olympics. And Indian Customs Compliance Information Portal was launched by CBIC, Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs, recently. It's going to offer the access to data related to custom procedures and regulatory compliance for all nearly 12,000 custom tariffs which are there. So data related to import, exports, everything is going to be offered on the portal. Chief Minister of Delhi Arvind Kejriwalji had launched Delhi at 2047 to make Delhi a global city by the year 2047. So this is a target for making Delhi a global city. So under this initiative, partnership will be established among private sectors, CSR initiatives and philanthropic organizations. Also, Delhi government has mentioned achieving 24/7 water supply across the city with immediate effect. RBI has imposed a monetary penalty on HP, that is Hewlett Packard Financial Service India Private Limited, recently. This penalty amount has been imposed by RBI on HP recently. Then we have 6 lakh of penalty imposed for not following certain norms which were supposed to be followed. And with this, we'll be winding up this segment. We'll see you in the next video with more news events. Till then, goodbye. Take care and have a wonderful day ahead, all of you.